Hey boys and girls, welcome back to Children's Church with Church for Entrepreneurs. Minister April here. So glad you could join us again today. We are continuing our subject of faith. We're learning more about faith. So excited you're here. Let's go ahead and pray. Father God, in Jesus' name, we thank you today for your word. Your word, Father, is a light unto our feet, a lamp unto our path. We promise to hide your word in our hearts that we will not sin against you. We ask right now, Father, for the presence of Holy Spirit here with us today. Holy Spirit, have your way. Move and manifest in our midst any way you desire. Give us wisdom, insight, and understanding of your word. We thank you for it now in Jesus' name and by his blood. Everybody in agreement, say it. Amen. All right. Let's open our Bibles again to, I believe we're going to go to, let's see, which one are we going to? We're going to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. Now, last week, boys and girls, we talked about walking by faith. We learned that faith is a lifestyle. And if you'll remember on last week, I had the house and I had the family here. And we talked about how believers are supposed to live by faith. It's supposed to be our lifestyle. We also talked about how we can use, faith is like using money in the grocery store. If you wanted to go and buy a basket full of groceries, you need some currency, you need money. And faith is that currency that allows us to reach up into heaven, use our currency, and believe God or pull down exactly what it is that we need from Father God. Today, boys and girls, we're learning another important principle of faith. And turn with me to 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. Once again, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. And it reads, "For we walk by faith and not by sight." Now, I'm going to use my little Lego friend here, and her legs don't move. Well, guess what? We're going to pretend like they do. We walk by faith and not by sight. Well, what does that mean, boys and girls? That means that when we are living a life of faith, we're not simply walking and operating by what we can see. In other words, there's going to be all kinds of things around you that say, "Hey, look over here. Hey, look over here. Hey." It's, in other words, there are things that capture your attention through your physical senses. But the Bible tells us when we operate, when we are walking by faith, we're not just going by what we can see. We're not using just what we can see with our eyes or what we can hear with our ears or what we can smell or taste or touch. Faith is not based on your physical senses. In other words, when you learn a little bit about Jesus and his disciples, one of them in particular, after Jesus died, he refused to believe. I wonder if you guys know his name. I'll wait before I tell you. But this particular disciple, he said, "I'm not going to believe unless I can put my finger in his hand and my hand in his side." In other words, he needed to see in order to believe. When you operate and live by faith, you're not just operating by what you can see with your eyes or what you can hear or feel or touch. So for example, if my family and I believe God to go on a certain vacation, well, it may not look like we have the money in our bank account to pay for that vacation. We may not have the physical plane tickets in front of us to go on that vacation. We may not have everything in front of us, but you know what we have? We have that currency. We have our money. We have the assurance, the promise from God that he would give us the desires of our heart. So we can go to God in confidence and we can go about our day every day in faith and in excitement, knowing that when we prayed for something, God heard us and he will answer our prayer. That's from 1 John chapter 5, verse 14. Turn there with your parents when you have a chance. Once again, that was 1 John chapter 5, verse 14. But today's verse says, "For we walk by faith." Say that with me. I walk by faith. Say that again. I walk by faith and not by sight. So we aren't walking just by what we can see. We are operating according to the word of God. So 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7, we walk by faith and not by sight. Next, I'm going to have you turn to Romans chapter 10, verse 17. One of my favorite scriptures as well. Romans chapter 10, verse 17. Romans is just a few books, maybe two books over from where we are in 1 Corinthians. So go ahead and turn there. Romans chapter 10, verse 17. Verse 17. Romans 10, 17. I wish I could sing. It's just not that good. I can sing. It just doesn't sound appealing to everybody. Okay. Romans chapter 10, verse 10. Chapter 10, verse 17 says, so then. In other words, get ready for an important point. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So I'm going to give you an example. I have some handy dandy headphones here. Faith, if we want to build our faith healthy and strong, faith comes by hearing. What do we need to hear? Do we just need to hear the coolest music that just came out? Do we need to hear a video? Do we need to just hear our friends talking or a TV show? Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So I'm going to splice this together. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. What? Faith comes by hearing the word of God. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. Faith comes by hearing the word of God. But guess what? You don't just hear it one time. You hear it again and again and again and again. So boys and girls, let's pretend something really fast. We're going to do two scriptures at once. But we walk by faith and not by sight. 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 Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. But we walk by faith and not by sight. We walk by faith and not by sight. Because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. I'm going to take this off. Of course, I told you I wish I could sing, but I'm just not that good. Faith, God kind of faith. Faith from the word of God comes by hearing the word of God. We're going to look at two other scriptures that are very important. Where they're found in Psalm number 1 and Joshua chapter 1. Psalm number 1 says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. So boys and girls, the ideal image of a blessed boy or girl, or a blessed man or woman of God, is verse 2. This person, they don't walk. Well, let's look at verse 1. This person doesn't walk according to the world. They're not just like the world. They're not like sinners. Sinners aren't their best friends. They're not who they're listening to. It's not what they're watching on TV or what they're trying to do in their everyday life. The blessed person that God is talking about here is a person who delights in the law or the word of the Lord. And they spend time reading and studying and thinking about this word day and night. Does that mean you have to be in the Bible, reading the Bible and speaking the Bible all day? No, but it means that it's part of your lifestyle. It's part of your daily habit of filling your spirit full of the word of God. Let's also look at Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. Because this is an important principle for success. And if you'll notice one thing with the principles of God, you'll see principles in the New Testament that he spoke about in the Old Testament. In other words, this is how God operates. This is the way that he wants us to live. Why? It's the way of victory. It's the way of prosperity. It's the way of success. So let's read again. Let's read Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. And it reads, this book of the law, or this book of the word of God, shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate herein or therein day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written here. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. So as we learned just briefly that faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God, then we also know that if this is our lifestyle, then this is something we do on a daily basis. So always remember, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. Spend time in God's word. Get the word of God into your heart, because that's how your faith is going to come. That's how it's going to grow. That's how it's going to get stronger. I love you so much. Have a blessed week.